Let me teach you how to create a Figma prototype. A prototype is an interactive representation of your product design. And a Figma prototype is a link where you can share with other people. And whenever someone opens up that link, they can directly see your design and then interact with your product design on that page. A Figma prototype can get really complex if you are working on a large-scale product. Take Instagram as an example. There's so many pages, so many interactions you can take on a single screen. However, even to this kind of complex and huge scale product, the core interactions of a prototype is very similar. And today I will teach you the core interactions you need to know to create a great prototype. First, a page level vertical scroll. Second, a component level horizontal scroll. Third, cross pages interaction. So if I click this icon, it takes me to another page. Click that icon to another page, this to another page. And finally, modals. So if you click a button, something pops up, and then it also pops out. Let's go. Let's go to Figma and create a new Figma file. You can name the file as prototype practice. Create a frame and select the frame size based on your mobile phone size. Let's create a wireframe that represents the homepage of an app. Add a rectangle on the top of the page to represent the app header. Then change its fill color to a darker gray to form more contrast. Now press T and then add a text box on top of the app header to represent a text. I'm just going to put in header. Let's quickly adjust its font and its position. Now let's copy the header and then paste it and move it to the bottom of the screen to represent the tab bar. Press R on your keyboard and create three other rectangles to represent three icons on the tab bar. Press R again to create another rectangle that represents a card on the app. Then let's Command-C or Control-C, Command-V or Control-V and copy these cards to represent three cards on this app. Now click Prototype on the top right and then set the device to your mobile phone device. Then select the entire frame and then hit the play icon on the top right. Here, we've created a prototype for this wireframe. And you can click the share prototype button on the top right to share the prototype link with other people. The challenge is to make this interactive. First, let me teach you how to do a page level vertical scroll. Go back to the design file, zoom out a little bit, select the frame, and then extend the length of the frame. And then select the entire toolbar and then drag it to the bottom of the screen. Now copy one of the cards and then paste it underneath to create more cards to fill the entire screen. And then adjust the length once again so that the entire page is filled with cards. Now if you go back to the prototype page, you can see that this entire page is already scrollable vertically. However, the header and the footer also scrolls once you scroll the entire page. Now let me teach you how to stick the header and the footer on the page. Please go back to the design file and select the entire footer. You can press Ctrl to make sure you are selecting all the elements here. Then right click and then select Group Selection. You can also use Command G to group selection. Now go to the right side and under Constraints, click the bottom line to make it stick to the bottom. Then check the Fixed Position box. Now go to the App header. Select all elements here and group these elements by Command G. Then check the Fixed Position box. Now if you select the entire frame and then play the prototype again, you can see that the entire page is scrollable, but the header and the footer always stick on the page. As a recap, increase the length of the page to make it scrollable. If you want to stick any element on the screen, select that element and turn on Fixed Position. Now let me teach you how to do a component level horizontal scroll. Let's go back to the design file and let's make the first card a bit narrower. Copy this card and paste more cards on the side. If you go back to the prototype now, you'll find that the page is still vertically scrollable, but horizontally it does nothing. So let's go back and let me teach you how to solve this problem. First, select all the upper cards and drag it out of the frame. Copy one of the cards and paste more cards on the side. Then select all the cards, right-click, and then select Frame Selection. Now drag this new frame back to the mobile frame. Now you are able to adjust the frame size without squishing the cards in it. Once you've adjusted the frame size to fit the font size, check Clip Content. Finally, go to Prototype, select this frame, and then turn on Horizontal Scrolling. Now if you go back to your prototype, you'll be able to horizontally scroll through the upper cards. You can always go back to readjust the size of the frame. The horizontal scroll will stay there as long as the frame width is smaller than all the cards' width. As a recap, to make a component horizontally scrollable on a page, first, frame the section, then adjust the size of the frame. Turn on Clip Content, and then turn on Horizontal Scrolling. Next, let me teach you how to create cross-pages interaction. Let's go back to the design file, double-click on the page title and then name it Page 1. Then copy this entire page and paste this page on the side. We are going to adjust this page to create a new page. Keep the header and the footer. For the other element, please either adjust the rectangles from before or create new rectangles to create a page like this. Once you are done, select the new frame and click the play button on the top right. You will be able to view this new page on the prototype page as well, but the two pages are still disconnected. So let's go back to the design page and make sure the right side is selected as prototype. Then select one of the icons and drag one of the dots to the other page. By this, you've created a navigation interaction. So once people click on that icon, it will direct them to the other page. Let's do this again. Select the left icon on the second screen, then drag one of the dots to page 1. By this, a user will be taken back to page 1 once they click the left icon. So if you go back to the prototype, now we can click between pages by clicking on the different icons on the tab bar. There's a different way to achieve the same thing. Let's go back to the design page, hit Ctrl-Z or Command-Z to go one step backward. Then select the left icon on page 2. Then on the prototype page, add an interaction by hitting the plus icon. Click on this new interaction, and then change none to navigate to page 1. This is a different way to create the same interaction as we created before. As a recap, to create a navigation interaction, click prototype on the design page, then select the element you want the interaction to start from. Then drag one of the dots to the page you want it to go to. Finally, let me teach you how to do an overlay effect. Let's go back to the design page and click F to create a new frame. This frame shall be smaller than your mobile screen. Next, use more rectangles to represent a screen like this. Now go to the second screen, select the icon representation, go to the prototype page, then drag the icon plus sign to the new modal page we designed. Under Interaction Details, change Navigate to Open Overlay. Now if we go back to the prototype and check out this new effect, we can see that once we click that interactive icon, it's going to open this page as an overlay to the page we were on. Let's further improve this. Go back to the design page, and then under Interaction Details, check both boxes. Add background behind overlay and close when clicking outside. Now if we go back to the prototype, we can see that this model is way clearer than before with the new background, and also you can close it by clicking outside the box. Finally, let's go back to the design page again and select the top right icon in the model. Let's add a new interaction, and this time, set the interaction as close overlay. You will see a cross showing up here, and if we go back to the prototype, this time, if you want to close the modal, you can simply click that icon, and it will close the modal for you. If you've came this far, you already know all the things you need to know to create a great prototype. But I just want to give you three more tips to save your time. The first tip is to download Figma app on your mobile phone, and then click Mirror on the bottom right. Then select any frame on your laptop. You can directly play with your prototype on your phone, and this is a more realistic representation of what you are designing. My second tip is to use component. For example, adding the interaction for the current bottom tab bar is not very difficult, but only because we only have two screens. Here, I'm adding a new screen to demonstrate what I mean. If you have a component that will be shared across many screens, drag it outside the frame. Right-click on it and then select Create Component. Then add all the interaction details into this component. For example, if you click on the first icon, it shall direct to the first page, the second icon to the second page, and the third icon to the third page. Then copy this main component and then paste it to the rest of the pages. Whenever you paste a main component, it will automatically become a subcomponent. And now, if you want to make any edit to this main component, all the subcomponents will reflect the change. And this is a huge time saver. My third tip is to shadow the user. You need to first open up the prototype link, then send the link to one of the users you want to test this on. And once another person starts using this prototype, you can click on their profile photo on the top right of the screen and then shadow their interaction with your prototype. So whatever they do with your prototype, you'll be able to see it real time. Congratulations, you've learned a lot today, and you can always go back to re-practice what you learned today. This video is part of my Figma tutorial series. So if you haven't checked out other videos yet, go check them out. And I have a little homework for you. I challenge you to create a prototype of your favorite app and include at least 5 pages. And once you finish that, comment your prototype link in the comment section below. And also check out other people's work and provide them some feedback in the comment section. I'm excited to see your work. And if you like this video, you'll also like this tutorial video that I made on Figma components and an in-depth walkthrough for Figma auto layout. So, see you in this video.